So I created a Trojan horse. Now, a Trojan is malware that is disguised as benign or harmless software. And the term derives from the ancient Greek story of the deceptive Trojan horse, which led to the destruction of the city of Troy. But what I did was I downloaded the Instagram app for Android, I injected my own code into it, and what that code does is it goes through someone's phone, downloads all the images, and sends them to a remote server that I set up. And this is all without the user knowing what's happening. So the steps I took, which I will be going more in depth in, are writing the malicious code, setting up our server where the images will be stored, then downloading the Instagram app from the Google Play Store, decompiling it with a tool called the APK tool, adding our malicious code to Instagram, and then recompiling Instagram with APK tool. And finally, installing it on my phone and seeing if it works. And if you guys stick around till the end, I will be doing a live demo of this to see if it works. Hopefully it works. I do want to say that this is solely for educational purposes. I do not condone the use of any malware against anyone. So please don't do anything that'll get yourselves arrested. And more importantly, don't do anything that will get me arrested. And lastly, I just want to say that over 90% of the people that watch this channel are not subscribed. So if you guys are enjoying the content and would like to see more, consider hitting that subscribe button. All right, let's get into it. All right, so the first thing I did was I created a brand new project in Android Studio, and I created a new class called Upload Pictures on Reboot. And this class extends the Broadcast Receiver class. So when an Android device reboots, it sends a broadcast to every application. And if they extended this class, they can have some sort of code that gets triggered on the broadcast. So our code actually isn't running while the user is using the app. It only runs when the phone gets rebooted. And what this code does is it gets the root directory of our phone and recursively searches through the file system, and anything it finds that ends in a .jpeg or .png, it takes that and sends it to our remote server that we haven't set up yet. In order to be able to send that picture, we do need to encode it to a base64 string, so we do that and then we post it to our server. Now, our post method uses an HTTP client called OKHTTP, which is developed by Square. So I'm using that to make a network request to post the image to our server. And this is really all the code that we need for our project. So let's go on to the next step, which is creating the remote server. So you can use really any hosting website that you want. I chose 000webhost.com just because I've used it in the past. So what I did was I created a new server called Trojan YouTube, and I went to the file manager there. The first thing I did was I created a new folder called Uploads. This is going to be where we store all the images we upload to our server. And I added a PHP script that'll handle the incoming request. So what this script does is it accepts that request that we're sending from the app, it decodes the base64 encoded image, and it adds it to that new uploads folder with the current time as the name of the image. And that's really all it does. So now that we have that set up, let's go ahead and download the Instagram app and inject our code into it. So all we need to do to get the app is go to the Google Play Store, search for Instagram, and copy the URL. Then we go to a site called apkpure.com and download the APK. Now before moving on, let me explain what an APK is. An APK, or Android package, is a container of all the stuff your phone needs to run the app. So it's really just like a zip file that contains things like all the code, all the images, the permissions required by the app, any type of third-party libraries your app needs, things like that. So now we have an APK of Instagram. We also need to get an APK of the app that we wrote. And you can simply do this by going to Android Studio and then just going to build and generate APK. So right now we have the Instagram APK and our app's APK, but we can't really do anything when it's in this format. That's because the code is compiled. And if we want to get our code inside of Instagram, we need to decompile both the APKs. We can do this with a tool called APK tool. This is a free tool that can take an APK and decompile it. It can also take the decompiled code and recreate the APK. So we decompile both of our APKs by using this tool on the command line. And you can do it with APK tool and then a D, and then the name of the APK. This decompiles the code into a language called Smalley. You don't need to know the language for this video, but just take note of that. So now if we go to our app's Smalley code, and we go to this path, we see two files called uploadPicturesOnReboot.smalley. This is the code that we initially wrote, but in Smalley format. Go ahead and copy these files. Next, we go to our Instagram Smalley code. We need to recreate the file path com example my application and then paste those two files into here. And with that, we have our code injected into Instagram. The last thing we need to do is we need to register our broadcast receiver. We need to go to the AndroidManifest.xml file. This file is kind of like the master file for the app that has important info like registering the required permissions, like accessing the camera or your location, and it is required in every Android application. So we simply go to the manifest and we paste this code into that. Now, the last steps we need to do is we just need to recreate the APK, sign it, and install it on a device. So to recreate the APK, it's really easy. All you need to do is you need to go back to the command line, type APK tool B, and then the name of the folder that we made the changes to. Now on every Android device, every application needs to be digitally signed before it can be installed. So we can do this using the tool called KeyTool, and I simply use these arguments here, answered a few questions, and it generates the key for you. Now what you do is you use another tool called JarSigner. You simply type JarSigner, you add the required arguments, then you add your APK, and then you add your key. So at this point, we have our Instagram app with our code injected inside of it. It's signed and it's ready to be installed on a device. Now, if this was a real hack, we would need to have some way of getting this app on a victim's device. This would be done with some kind of social engineering. That's outside of the scope of this video, but just know that that's something that you would need to figure out. So to install the actual app on this Android device that I have here, you just need to connect it to your computer and then simply go to the ADB tool, which comes with the Android SDK, and you just type ADB install and then the name of the app. So at this point, we do have Instagram installed on our device. And if you actually view Instagram from a user interface point of view, everything looks exactly the same, but it does have our code on it. So at this point, I'm going to try and upload a picture just so it asks for the appropriate permissions that we need. So I'm going to click allow. All right, so let's go to our remote server. Let's go to the uploads folder, and we see that we have no files currently in this folder. Now we need to just go ahead and take a picture here. Let's take an embarrassing picture that we wouldn't want people to see. And now we're gonna go ahead and reboot our phone and see if it uploads it to our server. All right, so at this point I am rebooting my phone. I'm hitting restart right now, restart. And let's give it a minute while it restarts and check and see if the files got uploaded. All right, so at this point our phone is back online, and let's go ahead and go back to the folder. Let's hit refresh. And there we go, we see that we do have images here. There are several images that I had from screenshots, but the one that I just took should be the most recent one. So if we go ahead and double click on that, there it is. We see that we have the picture that we just took, and now it is now uploaded onto our server. And now we can do whatever we want with it, right? We can right click, we can save it, or, you know, basically whatever we desire. So we've successfully stolen all of the photos on this device without the user knowing. So that's pretty wild. This happened on while the phone was rebooting, so the user has no way of knowing what's going on. And from the user point of view, Instagram will still work as expected. So as you can see, this is a pretty practical hack that you can do. As long as you're able to successfully get this app on someone else's phone, it works as expected. All right, so hopefully you guys found that video interesting. I know that there was a lot going on there. Hopefully I didn't lose all you guys, but I think this just shows that, you know, this was a very practical attack. It didn't really take that long for me to develop. And if you were able to trick someone and get them to install this on their phone, you would be able to get all the images on their phone. So that's all I wanted to cover in this video. If you guys did find the video interesting, make sure you guys smash that like button. Clicking it doesn't work anymore. You actually need to smash it. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and keep on coding.